In the globally harmonized system of classification and labeling, abbreviated GHS, chemical hazards are placed into three broad groups. Chemicals in the health hazard group cause, or are anticipated to cause injury, illness, or disease in humans. The physical hazard group includes chemicals that can be defined by physical properties or stability testing criteria. Uncontrolled physical hazards can cause damage to people or property. Environmental hazards threaten the aquatic environment, or the ozone layer. Each group is subdivided into classes. There are two environmental hazard classes, one of which, hazardous to aquatic environment, has subclasses based on exposure duration. There are 10 health hazard classes and 17 physical hazard classes. There is one chemical hazard, corrosive, that is a health hazard and a physical hazard. Within each GHS class, chemicals are designated into categories based on the severity of their hazards. Categories are shown here by black lines attached to the class circles. The most severe category is given the lowest number, 1, or the earliest letter, A, and is here represented by the shortest category line. There is no set number of categories per class. When you are evaluating chemicals for use in your classroom, minimize chemicals in low categories. The next part of the video will illustrate the GHS, including labeling information, for methanol's physical hazard of flammability. When we look at a safety data sheet or PubChem for information about methanol, we see that this common solvent is considered a flammable liquid, which is one of the 17 classes in the physical hazards group. This class has four categories, defined by the flash point, which is the temperature at which the vapor forms an ignitable mixture in air, and the boiling point. Methanol has a flash point of 9.7 degrees Celsius and a boiling point of 64.7 degrees Celsius. Therefore, methanol is a Category 2 flammable solvent, the second most severe category for that class. Now that we have the GHS classification for methanol, this identifies the hazard and precautionary statements that must be on the label. Instead of the alphanumeric H and P codes, the full text of the statements should be on the label. The pictogram and signal word are also defined by the category, and should be on the label. With the addition of manufacturer information, we now have all the label elements related to methanol's physical hazard of flammability. An actual methanol label must also include methanol's health hazards. You can use your knowledge of the GHS to create labels that consistently communicate chemical hazards to coworkers and students. Including pictograms and signal words dovetails with issues of universal design to transcend language barriers and help keep everyone safer.